No, this is my first time meeting fans at the convention. It's wonderful. People here are so excited about the show, and it's wonderful to have that feedback directly from the fans.
I mean, what do you think it is about the show that's made the fans so excited? Why do you think it's had this kind of tremendous response?
You know, I think the show has such a fan base and such a following because it taps into that idea of the supernatural and also kind of creatures and abnormals and people with powers, and people love the fantasy of that. But also there's the idea of being an outsider and yet there being a community, even if you're feeling alone or different, that there is a community, and I think people tap into that. My role on Sanctuary is that of Abby Corrigan, and I play an FBI agent. So she's this tough girl, but there is also a lot of fun and kind of sense of humor in it too. And then I also got the opportunity to sing in the show, which doesn't come along very often, so that was just a major plus.
A double whammy of awesomeness.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, playing a female FBI agent, what kind of inspirations were you looking at?
I really wanted her to seem intelligent and seem strong and seem like she could handle herself. And so, you know, you look at the strong female characters, anything like Jodie Foster has played, or even Amanda Tapping on Sanctuary. She's this really strong, capable woman. And so if we can kind of mirror that with Abby, then that was good. Amanda Tapping is one of the most wonderful human beings I've met and had the pleasure to work with. She is so generous and cheerful and professional and smart, so intelligent and funny. It just was an absolute delight. And then Robin Dunn, who I did most of my stuff with on Sanctuary, he's terrible to work with. Just kidding. No, he's lots of fun too. He's a bit of a prankster, always telling jokes. It's hard for us to get through a take without laughing.
I mean, what kind of pranks? What sort of things have he been doing to you now?
Oh, okay. My very first scene that I ever shot for Sanctuary, I was coming to the door to meet him, and I had to show him this folder that was going to be these things that I wanted his character to kind of go through. And I didn't look at the folder ahead of time. They just handed it to me. And I go into the scene and I open it up, hand it to him, and I look at it, and it's all just a bunch of headshots of him and like publicity and press photos of him. And they're all his glamour shots. And so I open it trying to be like this professional FBI agent, and there's all the Robin's glamour shots. Ridiculous.
Well, no nudes, hopefully, but
nudes.
All professional. I mean, clearly that was a wonderful on-set experience. Do you have any others? I mean, are there any particular sort of moments that you've really enjoyed on set?
My favorite episode was the filming of Fugue, which is the musical episode. It was such a special time for us. We got to work together in the recording studio, recording all the songs ahead of time, but then we had all these rehearsals on set, working out choreography for it also, and it was just a really special episode. It was really close to everybody's heart working on it, so it was good.
I mean, that was a wonderful episode. Talking about the other characters in the show, I mean, obviously you're working with some great people. Character-wise, who are you a fan of? Who do you just enjoy watching? Who do you enjoy sharing scenes with the most?
Well, Robin and Amanda are my two favorites. They're the two people that I get to act with most on the show, but it's always a lot of fun working with them.
And I mean, I guess an obvious question, what's coming up next for you? What are we going to be seeing you in over the next hour?
What I'm working on right now is a Canadian series called Arctic Air, and it's about a airline up in Yellowknife, which is a northern city in Canada. And so there's lots of kind of action and adventure and drama surrounding filming up north, because when you're filming in those, or not filming, flying, and when you're flying in those elements, like the extreme, extreme cold, there's just lots of adventure going on.
I guess it's an obvious question. Are you actually doing a lot of flying? Have you been getting up there in the Arctic air?
Only pretend.
Only pretend. Well, we're relieved to hear that.
Yeah, I am too. I think to fly, you need like 800 hours of.
Well, no, I didn't expect you to be flying, but I thought they might stick you in a co-pilot seat just to get experience.
Oh, they did do that. Yeah, they did do that. Yeah, yeah. We did do that on a couple different planes, and so that was really exciting because being up in the cockpit is a very different experience than being in the back, no matter what plane you're in. And so we did it in a couple small planes, but then we also used some DC-3s also. And yeah, it's a pretty phenomenal experience. And they sent us through flight school, so working with pilots in planes that were on the ground and kind of figuring out what levers and dials and all the panel and stuff, what you'd be looking at and what you'd be doing if you were actually flying the plane.
It sounds like there's a lot of tough challenges on that series. I mean, bring it back to Sanctuary. I mean, what was the hardest part of your role? What was the most difficult thing?
The hardest part on working with Sanctuary was mostly working with Robin Dunn, just because he has such an outrageous attitude, such an ego. No, in reality, Sanctuary, everything was just such a pleasure. In the first season, I was pregnant, and so that was a bit of a challenge all around, because the character wasn't pregnant. So we, as an actor and as the directors and the crew, we all had to work together to try and mask that and hide it as best we could. So that was a bit of a challenge.
I mean, that does sound. I'm always amazed when they do that on shows. How did you actually manage to pull that off?
Well, the bags got bigger and bigger as the series went on. Eventually, fortunately, it's sci-fi, and when I got too pregnant to hide it any longer, they just created an alternate reality, and in that alternate reality, Abby was pregnant, so we didn't have to hide it anymore.
It all works out.
Yeah, exactly.
Final question before you leave us and go back to meet more fans here. Have you got any message to all the fans watching this all around the world? Anything you'd like to say to them?
I would just like to... Should I say it right to the camera?
Yeah, give them eyeballs.
Okay, I just want to say thank you so much for welcoming me into the Sanctuary family for the last two seasons. It was an absolute pleasure. And I hope you continue to enjoy the show.